Now let's look at first question on the first law of thermodynamics. The question says, suppose 75 kilojoule of heat is supplied to a closed system at constant volume. During the next process, the system rejects 80 kilojoule of heat isobarically, while 10 kilojoule of work is done on it. So the work done and the heat rejection takes place isobarically. The cycle is completed with an adiabatic process. Internal energy of the system is 80 kilojoules. Find the amount of work transfer during the process. Which process? That is the adiabatic process. Okay, now if you look at this, this is basically a cycle. So do not confused by starting to write down the, you can say relations for constant volume processes, then constant pressure processes, and then adiabatic. No, it is a cycle. And for a cycle, the total or the net heat exchange is equal to the total net work exchange. This is for a cycle, simple. Okay, don't get confused. Now, there are three processes. The first process is constant volume. Okay, in the constant volume process, the heat supplied is 75. So you have minus 75 kilojoule of heat supplied. Okay, because it is a constant volume process, this is zero. So work done in this process is zero. Okay, during the next process, which is an isobaric process, so isobaric process. In this process, the system rejects 80 kilojoule of heat, so Q2 is minus 80. Okay, now see, changing the thing over here. So you are supplying this much heat, so this becomes positive over here. Okay, so this is being rejected, so this becomes negative. And you're also doing some work on the system, so work 2 is minus 10 kilojoules. Right, the third process which completes the cycle is adiabatic. So third one is an adiabatic process. The adiabatic process has no heat transfer through it, but it does have some work transfer. And this is what we need to find out. Okay, so we'll club Q1 minus this plus this equal to this plus this plus this. Simple. So you can join these and then you can join W's. Okay, so you will have 75 minus 80 plus 0 equal to 0 minus 10 plus W3. Okay. So this is minus 5 is equal to minus 10 plus W3. So W3 is equal to plus 5 kilojoules. So this is how easy it is. Just do not get confused with the question, I can say language. So very, very straightforward. The trick is to read this. It's a cycle. So it's a cycle means this is what you need to use. And this value of 80 kilojoule is not to be used anywhere. It's a superfluous data which is not being used. So this is how you look at a question and see what is to be done. So now let's move on to question number 2 on the first law.